Welcome to the Bible Quiz. Today, we embark on an enthralling journey delving into the ancient texts of the Old Testament. Prepare to unlock the mysteries hidden within its pages with 15 challenging questions crafted to test your biblical knowledge. But before we begin, remember to hit that subscribe button and show your support by giving this video a thumbs up. After the quiz, don't forget to share your score in the comments below. We're thrilled to join you on this captivating adventure through the Old Testament. Let's embark on this journey together and unravel its timeless truths. Let's get started. Question 1. What did God do on the seventh day of creation? A. Rested. B. Created Eve. C. Created man. D. Created light. You get 10 seconds. That's A. Rested. On the seventh day of creation, God rested from all his work, blessing and sanctifying it as a day of rest. Genesis chapter 2, verses 2 to 3. This day marked the completion of God's creative activity, emphasizing the importance of rest and setting aside time for spiritual reflection. The Sabbath became a sacred day of rest for humanity, reflecting God's pattern of rest after creation. Question 2. What did God place with the cherubim to guard the tree of life? A. Mighty lion. B. Flaming sword. C. River of sulfur. D. Four-headed beast. You get 10 seconds. That's B. Flaming sword. God stationed a flaming sword with the cherubim to guard the tree of life after Adam and Eve's expulsion from Eden. Genesis chapter 3, verse 24. This imagery symbolizes the consequences of disobedience and the separation of humanity from eternal life. The flaming sword serves as a barrier, highlighting the severity of sin and the need for redemption. Question 3. Who did God instruct to build an ark to ensure his survival? A. Seth. B. Isaac. C. Noah. D. Jonah. You get 10 seconds. That's C, Noah. God instructed Noah to build an ark to ensure his survival and that of his family, along with pairs of animals during the Great Flood. Genesis chapter 6, verses 14 to 22. This event illustrates God's judgment on humanity's sinfulness and his provision for those who walk faithfully with him. Question 4. What was the name of the place where God confused the language of all the people? A. Babel. B. Bethel. C. Babylon. D. Beersheba. You get 10 seconds. That's A, Babel. At Babel, God confused the language of the people who were building the Tower of Babel as a punishment for their pride and disobedience. Genesis chapter 11, verses 1 to 9. This event led to the dispersion of humanity and the formation of different languages and nations. Question 5. How many kings marched out in battle at the Valley of Siddim? A, 1. B. 2. C. 3. D, 4. You get 10 seconds. That's D, 4. At the Valley of Siddim, four kings engaged in battle against five kings, Genesis chapter 14, verses 1 to 9. This conflict ensued when King Chedorlaomer and his allies waged war against rebellious city-states. The ensuing battle resulted in the capture of Lot, Abraham's nephew, prompting Abraham to pursue and rescue him. This event demonstrates Abraham's bravery and loyalty to his family. Ensure you stay connected with us by subscribing. You won't want to miss the awesome quizzes and content we have in store for you. Question 6. What was the name of Ishmael's mother? A. Zilpah. B. Hagar. C. Sarai. D. Milcah. You get 10 seconds. That's B, Hagar. Hagar, Sarah's maidservant, became Ishmael's mother through Abraham, fulfilling God's promise of a son. Genesis chapter 16, verse 15. Ishmael's birth highlights the complexities of human relationships and the consequences of attempting to fulfill divine promises through human effort, illustrating themes of faith and patience in God's plan. Question 7. Who intercedes for Sodom when he learns God intended to destroy the city? A. Lot. B. Terah. C. Abraham. D. Moses. You get 10 seconds. That's C, Abraham. In Genesis chapter 18, verses 22 to 33, Abraham's intercession for Sodom reveals his profound compassion and unwavering faith. He pleads with God to spare the city if even a few righteous individuals are found. This act underscores Abraham's deep concern for others' well-being and his trust in God's justice and mercy. Question 8. Who was turned into a pillar of salt when she looked back towards Sodom and Gomorrah? A. Lot's wife. B. Lot's sister. C. Lot's mother. D. Lot's daughter. You get 10 seconds. That's A, Lot's wife. Lot's wife was turned into a pillar of salt when she looked back towards Sodom and Gomorrah, disobeying the angel's command during their escape. This serves as a cautionary tale about the consequences of disobedience and attachment to worldly things. Genesis chapter 19, verse 26. Question 9. What did Abraham purchase from the Hittites for 400 shekels of silver? A. City. B. Burial plot. C. Lake. D. House. You get 10 seconds. That's B. Burial plot. Abraham purchased a burial plot from the Hittites for 400 shekels of silver to bury his wife Sarah. This transaction, recorded in Genesis chapter 23, reflects the cultural practices of the time and demonstrates Abraham's reverence for his deceased wife. Question 10. What was the name of Abraham's second wife? A. Anna. B. Shua. C. Timna. D. Keturah. You get 10 seconds. That's D, Keturah. After Sarah's passing, Abraham married Keturah, who bore him children, extending his lineage. This union reflects God's fulfillment of his promise to make Abraham the father of many nations. Keturah's role underscores the continuation of Abraham's legacy and God's faithfulness in multiplying his descendants, as outlined in Genesis chapter 25, verses 1 to 4. Question 11. Why did Jacob flee to live with Laban? A. To seek refuge from a famine. B. He had sinned against God. C. To escape his brother Esau's anger. D. To find a wife from his uncle's family. You get 10 seconds. That's C, to escape his brother Esau's anger. Jacob fled to live with Laban to escape the wrath of his brother Esau, whom he had deceived and angered. This event, described in Genesis, chapters 27 and 28, marks the beginning of Jacob's journey of transformation and redemption. Question 12. What did Jacob see in a dream reaching up to heaven? A. Tree. B. Ladder. C. Cloud. D. Statue. You get 10 seconds. That's B. Ladder. Jacob saw a ladder reaching up to heaven in a dream at Bethel, with angels ascending and descending upon it. Genesis chapter 28, verses 10 to 19. This vision symbolizes God's connection between heaven and earth, affirming his presence and promise to Jacob. Question 13. What was the name of Jacob's firstborn child? A. Reuben. B. Judah. C. Dinah. D. Joseph. You get 10 seconds. That's A. Reuben. Reuben, Jacob's eldest son, was born to Leah as recounted in Genesis chapter 29, verse 32. His name, Reuben, signifies Jacob's expectation and longing for affection, the hope that at birth Jacob will acknowledge her. This story highlights the complexity of family relationships and the importance of names in expressing emotions and expectations. Question 14. Which two of Jacob's sons took revenge on Shechem? A. Asher and Dan. B. Naphtali and Issachar. C. Simeon and Levi. D. Reuben and Benjamin. You get 10 seconds. That's C, Simeon and Levi. Simeon and Levi, two of Jacob's sons, took revenge on Shechem for the violation of their sister Dinah, Genesis chapter 34. Their actions demonstrate the consequences of their anger and the importance of justice within the family. Question 15. How old was Isaac when he died? A. 70 years. B. 110 years. C. 147 years. D, 180 years. You get 10 seconds. That's D, 180 years. Isaac's lifespan reached 180 years before his passing, as detailed in Genesis chapter 35, verses 28 to 29. His death and burial, conducted by his sons Esau and Jacob, symbolize the continuation of his lineage and God's fulfillment of promises made to Abraham. Isaac's peaceful departure underscores God's blessings upon him and his pivotal role in the unfolding narrative of divine providence throughout the Old Testament. Oh wow, what an exhilarating journey through the depths of Scripture. How did you fare in unraveling the mysteries of the Old Testament? Whether you soared through the quiz or uncovered new insights, remember that the Word of God is an endless wellspring of wisdom awaiting exploration. If you relished this quiz, please consider giving the video a thumbs up and sharing it with your loved ones. Let's invite them to join us on this thrilling biblical adventure. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more quizzes and profound biblical insights. Your feedback is invaluable, so share your score and any questions in the comments below. Together, let's continue to deepen our understanding of God's Word. Thank you for journeying with us today, and may your spiritual path be illuminated with divine wisdom.